Hello and good morning from Proactive New York. Joining me today is Ben Gelfand, CEO at Bluesky Digital Assets. Ben, it's good to see you again. How are you?
Nice to see you again. I'm well, thank you.
That's good to hear. Yeah, we last caught up, it was around a year ago. So investors who are new to the story here, give us a quick intro into the company.
So Bluesky was formed as a private venture company in 2017. A group of investors and myself put together capital and built a test mine that we fired up in 2018. And in 2019, we took over a public company, basically a shell company, but it did have some assets and capital in it. And we refocused that shell company as a crypto mining company with a few blockchain applications. We ended 2019 mining, I guess, about $60,000 a month. And we took that up to sort of exiting the year about $400,000 a month. So we had a dramatic increase. And our mining thesis proved out well. We were a small miner among some of the mega cap miners that are out there. We, at the end of the year, we determined that we'd outgrown our operational facility in Canada and decided to move to a much larger space and much more power in the state of Texas. So we began demobilizing that facility at the end of 2021. And right now we're repositioning everything to grow in Texas.
Talk more about that in just a second, but you do have a background in capital markets. What is your take on cryptocurrency as an asset class compared to some of the others?
So first of all, it's new and the adoption rate is not as rapid as industry proponents would say. As an asset class, it's largely unknown. People seem to lump all of the different currencies and NFTs and stable coins and everything all into one group or one, I guess, entity. But it's really not. People in the industry know that it's not. There's Bitcoin, which is kind of the common carrier, the most talked about and most mined cryptocurrency, the most desired cryptocurrency. And then there's a whole universe of other stuff. There's stable coins that we've heard a lot about the last few weeks. There are NFTs, which are not coins. They're some kind of token. It's not something that we're involved in. And so there's a lot of information that needs to be sifted through. And, you know, people are clearly not getting educated by the media. So they need to educate themselves before they step into it. And then there's the public and private miners, which were a public miner. And that's a whole different ballgame because it's a stock based on the revenues derived from crypto mining. It's a whole other thing. So just commenting on the markets, you need to know what you're doing and what you're buying. People recommending things on social media is not a good source of investing advice, but there is plenty of credible material out there for people to educate themselves. And there are some good institutions that are putting out that information. That's kind of the state of the market right now. It's a new asset. It's extremely volatile and it ages people on management teams rapidly.
That's a good way to put it. Well, let's talk about the performance of the company. You recently reported your 2021 full year results. So how did you increase top line growth here?
We added miners. You have to do that. We also tweaked and optimized our mining so that we'd be more productive. We have lots of trade secrets around that, and it helps to be small when you're doing that, because on a small scale, it's not a lot of labor. It's, you know, you could do it with a small team. And it's also operational management skill. Like, it's great to have folks on your team that are passionate about cryptocurrencies and mining, but you also need to have the IT and electrical engineering background to make it all work and make it be stable and consistent. So that's kind of capital intensive, but we were able to raise $8 million or so, and all of that money raised ended up on our balance sheet. So it didn't slip away to SG&A or mistakes or trading mistakes or anything like that. We don't trade our crypto. We do liquidate it from time to time when we think it's right, but everything that we raised ended up on our balance sheet, and that's confirmed by our 2021 audit.
And you talked about the move from Quebec to Texas. You said that you had outgrown your facilities in Quebec. What are some of the advantages of being in Texas?
There's abundant power for us. The jurisdiction, the state of Texas, has written legislation around our industry to encourage us. There's abundant space. They have the workforce, skilled workforce in the industry that is migrating there from other areas. And it just seems to be a more business-minded jurisdiction, when it comes to our industry and probably a lot of other industries as well. So we felt welcome there, and it didn't seem like such a chore to get something done that you know we've encountered in other jurisdictions in terms of provisioning power and facilities and other things. So that worked for us. Our building was big enough, but we felt that it was older infrastructure and it was difficult to get the kind of power that we really wanted. And we have the power available now to scale up to be a big miner if we can pull it off.
So now, given the volatility in the market and given the dramatic drop in the price of Bitcoin we are seeing, how are you seeing 2022 shape up for you?
In terms of the volatility, I'm a seasoned capital markets veteran. So I'm old enough to have seen the crash of 87. It was, you know, my rookie year. So it's kind of baptism by fire there. And I've seen a bunch of other blow ups in markets. Do I think crypto is going to blow up and not come back? No, we're staying in it. We're actively taking the steps in the capital markets to acquire the capital and the equipment to grow and be a bigger miner. And we're agnostic to what we mine. As I said, Bitcoin's a common carrier. Everybody's mining it. There may be something else to mine at some point. I really don't care. I'm not in love with one currency or another. And, you know, if we need to sell coins at a high price, we'll do it because we think it makes sense and we have the capital markets expertise not to just sit there and hold it while it, you know, goes through one of these corrections. So that's what we're going to do. I mean, that's what we do. We build crypto mining, and you know, we have a few other side businesses that we're developing, but that's what we do. So we have no control over what people are doing out there on the markets, and we don't want to control it.
All right. Well, wishing you the best of luck for the rest of the year. Ben, good to see you. Thanks so much.
Thanks for your time.